In this video, we'll see how to cut a triangle in two equal parts, which means two parts having the same area, using a line passing through a point belonging to one side. Like this, you have the triangle ABC, a point M belonging to the side BC, and I've put here point I, which is the midpoint of BC, because we know that if we have M on I, that the solution is necessarily IA, because the two triangles ABI and AIC have the same area. So you can see that we have a line here, which is a ray in reality, and we can change the position. You see, we have displayed the areas of the two parts. Here, in this case, it's a triangle, and here it's a polygon. And here, it's a triangle and a polygon. So we can experiment and see that there is a position nearly here. You see? Where the area seems to be equal. And in order to conjecture something interesting, we have prepared the construction of a parallel line to AM. And you see that this point seems to be on this parallel. Is it always the case? Also, let us change the position of A, for example, and let us experiment to see where is this line from M in order to have the same, and you see that it seems that it is the case. So in order to obtain point M, to obtain this line, we have to display the intersection point of the parallel line to AM and this side. Let us validate that. We did the construction, you see, and we have constructed this line passing through this point, and you see that we have the same area. Is it always the case for all position of A? And you see that it is. So what about the proof? For the proof, it's very easy. So we construct AM, and you see that M can be constructed here, and the line passing through I, the parallel line to AM. After that, we construct this line, and we want to prove that we want to prove that this triangle has the same area of this one. But what we know, because I is the midpoint of BC, is that the orange triangle has the same area of the blue triangle. And we know if we see this trapezoid here in blue and in orange, we have the wing of the butterfly. And we know that the area of this triangle is the same of this area of this triangle. So if we cut the blue triangle and give it to the orange one, if we cut the orange one and give it to the blue one, we will not change the area of the two figures. Okay, you see, these two triangles have the same area, the theorem of the butterfly. So if we do what we did, we obtain the two areas which are the same. That's the proof of this result. We can generalize this result in order to cut a triangle in three equal parts from two points belonging to one side. How to do that? We cut this side in three equal parts, BI equal AIG equal J, AIJ equal JC. So we know that these three triangles have the same area. And if we do the same work as we did before, if we construct, you know, from here, line AM and AN, and if we construct the parallel line, the first one to AM and the second one to NG, and if we use the theorem of a butterfly twice, we obtain these lines and the three parts which are the line solution of our problem. And we know that the three parts we have displayed have the same area. If we change the position of A here, you can see that we have always the same area. That completes this video.